Hey there, this is, as far as I know, this is the end of Knights of the Old Republic here. We just gotta beat the shit out of Malik and we're done. I guess Bastila, we gotta slap the dark side out of her. Let's see if my blaster build holds up. We should be in really good shape though, just because the huge wisdom modifier on me, and you cannot resist the flamethrower. It will hit you. Hello?
Lord Malak, a team of Jedi have penetrated our defenses. Their fighters have landed on the Starforge.
This is not unexpected. The Jedi are formidable opponents. Send the Starforge's battle droids to deal with them.
Lord Malak, forgive me, but how can mere droids be a match for the Jedi?
You underestimate the power of the Starforge's droid army. Dispatch the droids.
Of course, Lord Malak.
I didn't buy any droid disruptors, and I don't have
the Jedi
droid.
Have invaded the Starforge. Destroy them. Destroy them all.
These fucking droids might put up more of a fight than the Jedi. Beep boop. Problem alert. My last build didn't make it to the final boss. My last build fell apart in the Starforge because I couldn't fight Jedi. I didn't keep a single... Oh, wait. Nope, I didn't keep a single ion blaster. Now, this is interesting. I don't know how to use... No, apparently I do know how to use blast rifles. 2 to 7 plus 2 to 12, so that would be 4 to 19. Which is... No, just this pistol alone does 4 to 19. Shit, I think I just tried to talk to him. Yeah, we don't actually have anything that's good against droids. Uh-oh.
Sure.
Oh, never mind. They don't have Doki. We're fine. We're fine. Beep, boop.
You're dead.
Oh, and for Zess, I don't think you're allowed to deflect from behind on a Jedi. So if I can stay behind him... Malik should get his blaster defense. Also, I'm assuming that he's not completely immune to force magic, and we might every now and then get a force paralyze off on him. Probably not, especially if he's got... Force immunity. Force immunity is a really weird spell because it's like, oops. Force immunity is kind of shitty because that means I have to waste a power on force breach, which I don't want to do. And I didn't do.
That'll show you.
There we go. Even this is a sneaky one. That's crazy. It's like if it's not their front 180.
This is what I...
Huh? I'm a little concerned about her supply of first aid kits.
Yes?
We have like 30, but we gotta get through the whole fucking Starforge with this. Got a little Master Valor. Let's get in there, fellas. Game volume seems a little higher, voice is low. Ah, is it? Oh, I think I see what I did. Because, yeah, I noticed my voice yesterday was low on the archive. Let's try something like this. I turned my microphone down. I noticed it was at the same setting that I turned the game volume down to. So I think I might have moved the wrong slider one day. Yesterday, to be precise. All right, blast him.
You're dead.
An assault droid built by the magical ancient space factory is having trouble holding its own against Candris with a stun stick. Is there an anti-melee droid weapon? There might be a sword that does ion. I don't think... I think the trick with droids is just like lightsabers and stuff go through. Beep beep. Melt those circuits and you just start poking.
Yes.
Time to get some free damage. There you go.
Sure.
Man, the regen on Candris is going to give us such a leg up item-wise. There's not a lot of guardrails here. Oh, look, the Jedis are in trouble. Shock. Nothing a force paralyze won't fix. Okay. The important thing is I waited for them all to die before I came to help.
More victims for us to
slaughter. Fucking Christ. Oh, why did I stand still and let them do that? I'm sorry, is it just the three of you? Because you're all going to fucking dreamland. Wow. Just leveled up from that war crime.
This is what I knew.
Yeah, like I said on one of the other streams, the last time I tried to go blasters, I was blaster rifles with Candris and HK, and fights like that fucked me up because I didn't put any in. I didn't take any crowd control powers. I just did all damage. Did like force lightning and drain life and shit. Did not work out. But the fact that I just choked those three guys out on the first try is a great sign. I think really only Malik's gonna give me trouble in here, unless they got some really dopey shit left farther in. This door's locked. Oh well. Silly me. I didn't play any of the Star Wars games as a kid, no. I think the only other Star Wars game I played was that, like, Age of Empires Star Wars spinoff. Galactic Battlegrounds. Oh no, look out. Unnamed Jedi. I just run down the hall like fucking the Bionic Man. $6 million. And just paralyze you. Like, that's just all you see. I don't even want your treasure. It's all gonna be shit. Beep, beep. A lot of guys here look like Darth Brandon.
Why have you disturbed me?
I have news, Lord Malak, about the Jedi.
The Jedi. Did my droids pass their test? Did they destroy our enemies?
No, Lord Malak. The droids could not stop them.
Strange. I did not think there were any among the Order who could survive an attack by an army of the Starforge's battle droids.
It was Revan, Lord Malak. Your old master is with the Jedi here on the Starforge.
Yes. That would explain why the droids failed. Revan was always strong in the Force. Very well. Send out all available troops, the apprentices as well.
Do you think they can stop Revan, Lord Malak?
Of course not. But they will slow Revan down. That will give me the time I need to fully prepare the Starforge's defenses. I am curious to see the true extent of this space station's capabilities. One as powerful as my old master will make an interesting test subject.
He called it an army of droids, and I think I got attacked by six. So there's been some major bureaucratic miscommunication here. Oh, hello. Just one at a time. Work your way down the line, fellas. I want to try to get all four with one flamethrower here. Never mind. Big iron's in my way. Boop.
Huh? Yes?
Malik's just sending these fucking guys to die. Well, let's go. Oh, hey, fella, were you late? Let me get this straggler here. Don't fucking touch me.
Here it is.
You don't even need to deflect blaster bolts, you just fucking dodge them with 30 AC. Ridiculous. Whoa, nice try. Nighty night. Good guys. Not even gonna paralyze you. Look at these dudes.
Here it is.
Oh, double pistol. Fellow Big Iron, you're dead. Looking at me? I don't like that. Man, someone skipped grenade class. Did you see the fucking adventure his grenade went on? It's over there somewhere. Top up. Didn't even use force speed there. Now I will, though, because I see another friend coming. I'm going to sniper shot them, actually. That was weird. It canceled. Well, there you go. I feel like the villain in the opening of a JRPG just... Stop, Revan, he's attacking our town. I'll get overconfident and this one Sith trooper will kill me and he gets to be the protagonist. He did it, he stopped Darth Revan. Man, they just keep coming, huh?
Good.
This is probably where my blaster guy had trouble. Just the fights won't stop. No, we don't want that. We want just flurry. I think sniper shot needs to be max for it to compete with the extra attack. Let's not get ahead of ourselves here, though. I'm actually going to run out of force power in a moment. I'm going to have to stop casting shit. Get this guy before he thaws out. By the way, Candris, great job having full health still. I'm not going to level up T3 because it's a free heal. So we can do like a greasy combat heal with that. I need my force magic. But. Let's just keep going anyways without it like an idiot. Oh yeah, this is where the cutscene was. A chain gun turret. Some T-posed Sith troopers. Almost there. Don't you fucking touch me. Nothing gives you that right. That would have been a lot better if I didn't fucking finish my attack animation. I'm dead. Some Jedi, huh? Nothing a little fire won't fix. They're actually winning. I got fucked there. Candris can probably win this by himself, but it'll be quicker if I don't die there fighting the Jedi. Ah, Christ. That is frustrating when you're like, do this. It's like, hang on, I'm not done casting rapid shot on this corpse. Let's get the guns later. T3, what are you doing over there? Get the fuck out of there, little dude.
What?
No, I don't think droids are allowed to use lightsabers. This fight over these, definitely some endurance fights here. I could definitely see how just all blaster rifles would fall apart. Because we negate a lot of damage by stunning all the Sith. I think Candrus is just going to regenerate all that poison damage. He is really fucked up though. Hey, fellas. There we go. Good.
Die!
Where'd you come from? Oh, no. It's a lot of fucking guys they throw at you. A replicator box. Hey, do you fucking mind? I'm trying to steal your stuff. My God, does it ever end? Alright, well this is just too many guys, Jesus. I hope they don't endlessly spawn. You could get screwed pretty easily. Jesus Christ. Can I open this?
No problem. Didn't work.
Didn't work. Hello? Star Force defense is engaged. Yes. Generate light battle armor. Generate battle armor. What? Oh! Generate customized Jedi robes. Neat. I don't know if I want the Durasteel heavy armor though. I think I've seen Durasteel heavy armor and it's not good. What is this? Jedi clothes. I think these might be good. Starforge robes. Yoink. You guys okay out there? You look alive. Alright, level up. Computer use, repair, security. Okay, accept. What are these? 5 plus 8 and then wisdom plus 2, but what are these? No wisdom. Nope, there it is. Sorry. Created by the mystical technology of the Star Forge, these robes focus the inherent force abilities of the wearer, fueling their power. Although the Starforge itself is an artifact of the dark side, these robes were customized using an analysis of the Jedi they were created for, resulting in a powerful light side item that the Jedi can safely use against their enemies without fear of taint or corruption. All saves plus two, so it's better. Ooh, look at that. Okay.
What?
What do we have here? Slice this one. Huh, I think these are the same. Hang on, let's not waste any spikes here, right? Oh, look at these are free. Deactivate the sentry guns. Make my life a little bit easier. I think that's just the shitty heavy armor we've seen before. Heavy battle armor, light battle armor. I think light battle armor's dog shit. Hope that didn't destroy the old armor. We're gonna find out. Three computers that do nothing but make armor. That's odd. Yeah, I think I've seen both of these. Can't make helmets? Nope. Okay. Durasteel heavy armor, which, yeah, you really don't want to be wearing this. Compared to the other shit we have access to.
Sure. Huh? Yes?
Alright, let's go, fellas. A little bulkier than my old robes, but my god, there's more. The problem with running is I can't zone out if my companions aren't with me. So unless I can force them to not go into combat. I turned off the turrets. These are my friends now. What do you want to bet? They're still fighting shit. Yeah, this. I think they're getting the shit kicked out of them by Jedi right now. Yep, I gotta gather my party. Okay. That's neat. Room. Let's grab a room. The command. Wait, command center? No, we gotta fight Basilisk still. We can't be at the end already.
Master, why have you summoned me? Without my battle meditation, there is a chance the Republic capital ships could break through and attack the Starforge itself.
This will not take long, Bastila. You will be able to resume your battle meditation soon enough. I only wanted you to know that Revan is here on the Starforge,
Revan, but...
The forces bring us towards a confrontation with my old master. The Starforge has drawn our enemies together, so they may all die in a single, glorious day. You must kill Revan to prove yourself worthy of being my apprentice, Bastila. You must finish what began in the Rakatan Temple.
Yes, Lord Malak.
I sense your fear, Bastila, but it is unfounded. The power of the Starforge will feed the dark side within you. It will give you the strength you need to defeat my old master. Stay here in the command center while you use your battle meditation against the Republic fleet. Revan will find you here in due time. It is inevitable.
Of course, Master. I will not fail you again.
I guess we gotta beat her up first.
Perhaps you will triumph, Bastila. But even if you fail, it will give me the time I need to complete my preparations of the station's defenses. And then we shall see if Revan can stand against the full fury of the Starforge.
I don't know what that would entail. Also, it's a little silly that a Bastila's special power lets her buff people thousands of miles away in their spaceship, but I have trouble buffing Candrus if he's more than like 20 meters from me. Not this shit again. Better not be infinite. That was dumb. I thought I paralyzed them, but they just turned their shield on. Well. I see you. Fuck. Where's my super med kit? I just got a bail. See ya. Where did you guys come from? You came from fucking behind, didn't you? Cook these ones for me, would you? Yeah. Oh, now I gotta do this fight without T3. No, let's not do this life drain spamming shit, please. Oh my fucking god. Who thought infinite enemies was fun? Like, of course I fucking ran into force powers. It's like 30 dudes. What? Alright, get up. Are you gonna fucking spawn more infinite enemies on me? Thank god. So it looks like it's not infinite, it's just a really frustrating amount. Which way did I come? Now we pretty much just have to stand here till I get all my force magic back. Well, you can't heal yourself. You gotta do this.
Sure.
Huh? What?
Okay, I don't have all my force, but I'm not in a waiting mood. Does that look like treasure? But I don't need treasure. Actually, I wonder if I can zone out in solo mode. And then just force speed to the next door. Not a lot of stuff. That's a weird... What the fuck is this? No way. Gonna make me fight a gaggle of dudes for fucking one medkit? Thank you. did you guys just force paralyze a door? And they're spawning in between me and the, okay, it's fucking monster closet garbage. I'm gonna die here because I can't fight this many Jedi by myself. Okay, you can fuck off with that, please. There goes T3. I don't have high hopes for this cutscene. Nope, I sucked him up.
Revan, I knew you'd come for me.
Hello, thank you for magically teleporting my companions here. I'm Big Iron now, though, by the way. Revan's no more.
Sadly, I know this is true. Had you reclaimed the power of your previous identity, I would be your apprentice, not Malak's. But you rejected the dark side. Now you must pay the price. Here on the Starforge, the power of the dark side is at its strongest. This time, you will not defeat me.
Oh, we're just doing it solo? Well, that kind of works out, because I was here by myself anyways. Huh? I mean, I am missing most of my health, which is a slight problem. Apparently, I brought my Enviro suit with me. Neat. I need the super health pack. And then just keep doing this till it works, basically. She can't resist indefinitely. I don't care what fucking level she is. But if she just gets a free attack every time, I'm dead already. Oh, thank God. Okay, okay. Another first aid kit. I meant to take the super drugs there, actually.
There. I see now why Malak followed you. Even though you're only a shell of your former self, you're still a formidable opponent. I can't even imagine the power you must have wielded when you were the Dark Lord. You were a fool to give it all up and follow the light side.
Don't you fucking start a second phase of this fight after I just wasted all my force stunning you. I am as strong in the light as I ever was following the dark side. I got this new robe.
The dark side has made me stronger than I ever was before. I have a greater command of the Force than all but the most powerful Jedi Masters. As Malak teaches me the greatest secrets of the Sith, I will unlock more of my potential. Eventually, there'll be no limit to what I can accomplish with the Force.
I mean, Malak will kill you first. That's like Sith 101.
Have you forgotten the ways of the Sith already, Revan? Eventually, I will challenge my Master. If I am worthy, he will die by my hand, and I will become the new Sith Master. Then I will take on my own apprentice, and the cycle will begin again. This is the way of the Sith. It is how we assure our leaders are always the strongest and most worthy.
But you're dooming yourself to an endless cycle of death and betrayal. God, I hope my bane is regenerating right now.
No, Revan. It is you who are doomed.
You're goddamn right she healed me. I'll take a stimulant here. Unfortunately, I can't get one for wisdom, man. Imagine if you could get some magic drugs. That's what I like to fucking see.
The Starforge has made me even more powerful than ever, Revan. Ow! Stop shooting me.
You're growing weary. I can sense it. Your strength falters. The light side is failing you while the power of the Starforge re-energizes me. Soon this will all be over.
I've not faltered, Bastila. You've been incredibly misled by the dark side. You spent that last fight paralyzed. Then strike me down. I won't defend myself. Ah, that's a risky game over right there. I am wearing a billowing robe I can melt away into. You've been misled by the dark side.
The dark side will always triumph over the light. Malak has assured me of victory. You can't defeat me here on the Starforge. You can't.
Oh my god, thank god we're getting healed at least. Oh, the drugs persist, but I get healed. Thank you, Starforge.
This is not possible. You have rejected the dark side. You are a weak and pathetic servant of the light. How can you still stand against me? Why can't I defeat you?
I rolled higher than you with my d20. I am stronger than you could ever be, Jesus Christ. These fucking quotes. Now you see the dark side is not stronger than the light.
Yes, I see you speak the truth. I am no match for you. Please, for the sake of what we once shared, do not make me suffer. End my life quickly. There is no other way.
I could never kill you.
What other choice do you have? I have fallen to the dark side. I am the apprentice to the Dark Lord himself. You cannot let me live.
You can reject the dark side. I was redeemed too. Maybe we could crash a spaceship into you and erase your memory.
You were a special case. The Council had no other choice. They needed you alive so they could discover the location of the Starforge. It was an act of desperation. It was my responsibility to watch over you, to make sure you did not slip back into your evil ways. I was supposed to protect you from the dark side.
You can't protect someone from the dark side. Each individual must choose their own path.
I suppose you're right. But the path I have chosen is that of the dark side. I don't see any way I could atone for what I've done. I deserve to die.
Oh, now's not a time to go cry, baby. I don't love her, but what if you were to look in your heart and notice that the Force loved you?
I know a flicker of the light still burns within me. Malak felt it too. He knew it could only be extinguished if I killed you. But what good is a single flicker of light against the sea of darkness I am drowning in? I can never atone for my betrayal.
But I don't love her. You should just atone by helping us defeat the Sith.
Yes, I could join you in your battle against the Dark Lord. That alone would not make up for all I have done. Yet it would be a step in the right direction. But how would you be able to trust me? How do you know I wouldn't turn on you when you faced Darth Malak? How do you know the dark side wouldn't make me betray you again?
I trust you enough to leave myself open to your attack, Bastila.
You play a dangerous game. Are you certain you wish to take this risk? I could end your life and gain Malak's favor with a single stroke of my lightsaber.
I love you and believe in... I know you serve the light.
You are brave and foolish. The dark side has wholly consumed me, and you will suffer for failing to see that.
Well, joke's on you. Big Iron has no problem with being single, girl. Because, you know, love can lead to the dark side, so... She's not getting that dick. Fight on, brave soldiers. All the Trask Uggos out there.
There, a break in the Sith formations. Green Squadron, move in.
Green Squadron, moving in. Green Squadron's through. We've broken their lines.
There's a lot of you guys.
Astra is no longer using her battle meditation against us. The tide has turned.
Red Squadron, into the breach. Capital ships, reinforce their position.
It's literally... Oh, they didn't get sucked up. That's a little weird. Don't tell me I gotta beat the game solo. Uh-oh is our backup save. Let's go with a better damn well. It's weird because we're at the factory that infinitely makes Sith ships, but their fleet isn't strong enough to fight off the Republic, even though the Republic's losing the war, supposedly. No one stumbled upon this gigantic space station before now. I think the stipulation is that you always crash land on the Rakatan planet if you find the Star Forge, and Revan was the first one to escape. And also, yeah, you can't just fly wherever you want in space. You basically take hyperspace routes, which they haven't all been mapped because it's not worth it. A Type B spike bin. That's weird. Hello? Generator inactive. Okay. What the fuck am I looking at here? A puzzle? Really? I just fought Bastila to the death solo, and they're like, what about a hacking puzzle next? Hello, Darth Malak? Just choking the chicken in here without me, are you?
Oh. I tire of this game, Revan. You have been a thorn in my side from the moment I seized the mantle of Dark Lord from your feeble grasp. You made a mistake coming here, Revan. The Star Forge fuels my command of the dark side. You are no match for me here, and this time you will not escape.
This whole fucking sequence just made my build canon. Cause I just opened the door and he's just got these two guys fucking stunned and he kills them both. That's how I taught him to fight. Surrender and the Jedi might show you mercy.
Is that what you call it? You think stripping away your power and your identity was an act of mercy, Revan? I would rather die.
I was saved from darkness. You can be too, if you wish.
Spoken like a true slave of the Jedi Code. Save your preaching, Revan. I will have none of it. You are an insignificant speck beneath my notice. I have surpassed you in every way and accomplished what you never could. I have unleashed the full potential of this Rakatan factory. You had no idea of the power within this place. Its very walls are alive with dark side energies. And now, my old master, I will let the Starforge itself destroy you.
Oh my god, don't be infinite. What is this? I think I have enough spikes to just kill all the generators. I thought I convinced her too, Justin, but she went rogue at the last second on me because I wouldn't give her my big iron. No, don't fucking shoot him past speed. I literally didn't click you. There goes that one. I still gotta kill all these droids once I break their generators. I don't have enough spikes. Uh-oh. One's still on. Thermal detonators it is. I'll have the Starforge itself destroy you. I'm just doing cartwheels around these things, shooting point blank at me. Whoa, you wish. Big iron. God, I wish I had destroyed Droid right now. I'd be in heaven. Just give myself some breathing room to cast heal a couple times here. Immediately, I maybe have to disengage to stop that behavior. That's a strong heal too. So I think only one or two generators are still on. Oh, maybe they generate spikes when I kill them. Yep. That's enough to break the final generator. Okay. You wait right there, robot. Yeah. Thank God I had enough spikes, because what a dumb puzzle. Yeah, just lock him in a room with a bunch of robots. Why? Why? Better save you. Basically, I just need to be doped out of my fucking brain before the Malik fight starts, and then we stand a really good chance. All right, there he is. Will the Jedi Council notice that your arm is covered in track marks from all the stims you inject? They don't do spot checks like that. Not a problem. I want hyperdex for even more movement speed. Let me super battle stimulant. Four up arrows on my character.
Well done, Revan. I was certain the defenses of the Starforge would destroy you. But I see there is more of your old self in you than I expected. You are stronger than I thought. Stronger than you ever were during your reign as the Dark Lord. I did not think that was possible.
The light side and the drugs running through my veins are stronger than you know, Malik.
I am tempted to try and capture you alive, Revan. Then I could break your will and bind you to me as my apprentice, as I did Bastila. You'd be a far greater asset to me than even Bastila and her battle meditation, if I could control you. But is it worth the risk? Perhaps you are too powerful to be my apprentice. I betrayed you when I realized my own strength was greater than yours. In time, you might try to do the same to me.
That is literally what the Sith do. I'll never serve the dark side again, though.
Foolish words. The darkness and the light wage a constant war within you. The balance is tipped one way now, but it can easily be tipped back. Savior, conqueror, hero, villain, you are all things, Revan, and yet you are nothing. In the end, you belong to neither the light nor the darkness. You will forever stand alone.
I did have friends, but the story took them away from me. This is your last chance, surrender?
No, Revan. This time our confrontation can only end in death. Yours or mine. Once again, we shall face each other in single combat, and the victor will decide the fate of the galaxy.
All right, let's see if our build works. He took my drugs away while we were talking. Fucking cheater, man. I don't really have... If I get a stun off, I'll have enough time to take all my drugs, but then we'll have to stun him again, because I think it'll take the exact duration of the stun to put all my drugs back in me. I mean, really, we can't lose, because basically we just load the game until the stun hits, and then we win. I mean, the fight is over if I get you, but you're not resisted every time, strong dude. Ah, that fucking really sucks. He purges all my buffs. Because he's going to just get a bunch of free shit off while I cast all my buffs. I have to cast my force resistance and shit, I think. I guess I could also cast my Mandalorian shield.
Well done, Revan. You are stronger.
Surrender?
Once.
So he fights a lightsaber, so I want... Energy 40? That's dog shit. Energy electrical will protect me against this force lightning and shit. Okay, I think I can get plus defense with the battle stimulant. No, that's just plus damage. No, wait, I gotta cast. What's the other dumb one? Let's just look him up. Look at that dramatic profile picture I have, though. Oh. What are my powers? Plus 4 bonus to all saving throws for 20 seconds, but then I have to cast it. So this is all stats and saving throws by 5, but then this is... protects me against this shit. I should probably cast Force Immunity. And then I also want the big save on Master Valor. I can't turn the shield on through the menu. I have to waste a turn doing it. Jesus Christ, he fucking eats right through that thing. 52, dude? There we go. Now we're cooking with fire. I can't remember. Am I taking the super stimulant right now? Yes, okay. I don't have super speed on right now. Super speed lasts the longest, though. We do this, and then we do this. I think we're going to run out of force power, and then we just got to try to burn them down. I don't think that's going to work out. Yeah, could you maybe not do fucking 70 damage every turn, asshole? Jesus Christ. Oh, we're gonna have to be a lot greasier here. I wasn't expecting to fight the final boss by myself. That's a little shitty. I can't even fucking medpack through this. I just gotta go for it. I just gotta keep shooting, hope he doesn't deflect at all.
You continue to amaze me, Revan. If only you had been the one to uncover the true power of the Starforge, you might have become truly invincible. But you were a fool. All you saw was an enormous factory. All you ever imagined was an infinite fleet rolling forth to crush the Republic. You are blind, Revan. Blind and stupid.
What?
The Starforge is more than just a space station. In some ways, it is like a living creature. It hungers. And it can feed on the dark side that is within all of us. Look around you, Revan. See the bodies? You should recognize them from the Academy. These are Jedi who fell when I attacked Dantooine. For all intents and purposes, dead. Except for one difference. I have not let them become one with the Force. Instead, I have brought them here. The Starforge corrupts what remains of their power and transfers the dark taint to me.
Okay.
You cannot beat me, Revan. Not here on the Starforge. Not when I can draw upon the power of all these Jedi. And once you are beaten, I will do the same to you. You will be trapped in a terrible existence between life and death. Your power feeding me as I conquer the galaxy.
So, this guy's a fucking murder machine, and I gotta solve a puzzle without my party. I'm fucking very underwhelmed by this fight, let me tell ya. The Jedi hangs in the grasp of the electrical prison. Only by using the power of the Force could you free him now. I don't know what the fuck that means. The Force power did not affect the Jedi captive or the machine that binds him. Okay. Okay, so I'm just getting poked. Who the fuck thought this up? Call this one what? Just gonna chip away at me here. That's cool. Oh boy. I have my super speed. I'll take my force immunity. Can I shoot them? I don't think so. It has to be the force, but I don't have any offensive force power. If I have to fucking use a lightsaber, that's even stupider. Did he paralyze me? No, okay. I don't have any lightsabers. I'm not allowed to use them. Dark side only? Oh, it's because I have an offhand. Nope. Like, are you for real, game? Okay. So I have to kill him 9 times because I didn't buy an offensive force magic. So did it happen again? Did the fucking game not work at the end? Did I fucking manage to pull it off once more? Jesus fucking Christ.
What a fucking major lack of oversight. I can just kill the Jedi myself instead. It's still a fucking slog to kill him by myself. Don't know why they felt the need to take away my party that I had for the entire fucking game. And then I just stopped attacking him for some fucking reason. Oh my god. Why can it never just be a regular fucking video game? Why does it always have to get stupid at the end? What the fuck is this? Does he just wait to run into magic? Hey! Ugh, what a fucking... I'm gonna die here. Stop attacking him, just fucking use it. Yeah. What am I looking at here? We can just spam energy shields, I guess, and shoot him. Gotta nudge him, I guess. You're gonna die because you fucking insist on auto attacking. Nope. What a fucking awful boss fight. Why would you do this? Who made this? If it's got to be different from the rest of your game, just don't do that. Got a bit of a med pack problem here. There he goes again. What the fuck? Maybe I just have to get him near a body when I hit him? Jesus Christ, I'm still cut up. Is that shield gone already? Yeah, I need a new one. Try to cheese it with mines. My demolition's very low. I think I sold everything. I just have these two plasma mines I found. No. Yeah, turn to face him. Great plan.
Didn't work.
See, I'm too stupid to place them. Because your demolitions determines what you place. Thermal detonators might work? Yeah, I guess that's true. I do have a lot. Because you still take damage on a resist there. What? Yeah, that works. I am just so fucking unimpressed with this fight. Like, the build fell apart because they just changed the rules on me. It's like, yeah, you gotta not use your party. And there's this dopey mechanic that drags out the fight. My god. There, go suck another one off, fella. Fun shit. I can suck him off too. I don't have any magic. All I know is stasis. The frustrating thing here is the game, like, the blasters were viable right up until this point. We were making it work. And the game was okay with that, and then they just spit in my face for this fight. Ridiculous. Like, there's no point in wasting my time casting stasis field on this guy. I'll throw the grenades. Please fucking heal yourself like I told you to. Okay, off you go, man. This is so fucking dumb. I had an auto attack there, which I didn't mean to queue up, and now I fucked up the grenades. No, whoa. I said use it. There we go. Oh my God.
Impossible. I cannot be beaten. I am the Dark Lord of the Sith.
I hope whoever made this fight got fucking fired. That was a disgrace. Power of Light will always be stronger, even when you cheat.
Still spouting the wisdom of the Jedi, I see. Maybe there is more truth in their code than I ever believed. I cannot help but wonder, Revan, what would have happened had our positions been reversed? What if fate had decreed I would be captured by the Jedi? Could I have returned to the light as you did? If you had not led me down the dark path in the first place, what destiny would I have found?
Can't blame me for the path you chose, you cheater.
I suppose you speak the truth. I alone must accept responsibility for my fate. I wanted to be master of the Sith and ruler of the galaxy. But that destiny was not mine, Revan. It might have been yours, perhaps, but never mine. And in the end, as the darkness takes me, I am nothing.
There you are. What happened?
Yeah, thanks for the fucking help up there, you guys. I killed him. There was no way to turn him to the light side. He was in love with his weird little manservant tubes.
I don't think that anyone actually expected that he could be redeemed. Surprised you'd even think of trying. No time to celebrate just yet. With Bastila dead, the Republic has broken through the Sith fleet. The capital ships are in bombardment range. And that means we all have to get out of here right now before this entire complex comes down around our ears. Everyone else is already on the ship. Let's move.
Admiral Dodonna, we've hit their main orbital stabilizers.
Everyone pull back. I don't want to lose any ships when that space station goes down. We did it, Vandar. The Sith are routed, and the Starforge destroyed.
But at what cost, Admiral? Where is the Ebon Hawk and her crew?
How was the fight with the governor on Terrace? It was a pretty easy fight. There were really only two fights that were difficult. Darth Bandon, who wore armor, even though you can't wear armor and cast most magic. And then Malak just now.
I'm sending an honor guard to escort you in. You'll be getting a hero's welcome when we all get home.
Bendak Starkiller was also a semi-hard fight, but that was like before we had the stun and stuff, so...
You have defeated Malak, destroyed the Starforge, and broken the spirit of the Sith. For this, I am proud to present you each with the Cross of Glory, the highest honor the Republic can bestow. From Coruscant to the farthest reaches of the Outer Rims, you will be known as the Saviors of the Republic.
I did pretty much 100% Tara, so
on
I was very strong.
Of
but
the Jedi Council,
the governor was pretty easy with sneak
of
attack.
The galaxy and sworn protectors of the Republic, I too would like to honor you for your actions. We Jedi now have another tale to weave into the grand history of our eternal order: the redemption of Revan, the prodigal knight. Wherever you go, you will be recognized as the saviors of the galaxy, the heroes of our age. But you must remain ever vigilant, for one day you may be called upon yet again to defend the glory of the Republic against the tyranny of the dark side. For this is the destiny of the Jedi.
Would I go blasters in Knights of the Republic 2? I think it's actually easier to make a blaster build in the second one, Fat Pep, but my fucking god. I'm so mad because the build worked for like 90% of the game, and then they just had to throw in that trashy Malak fight. Wow. It's like, first, we'll take away your party, so if you're a scoundrel, you can't take advantage of your passive sneak attack. And then we'll make him all three classes at once. And then we'll also add this weird mechanic where he keeps healing himself, which isn't anywhere else in the game. Ah, oh, fuck. Blaster build worked for everything up until that fight, and then they just shit in my mouth and told me to swallow. But I did. I swallowed it. And I chased it with 30 thermal detonators.
The spicy meatball.
Quality assurance lead Scott Langan, shame on you for letting that boss fight go through. Oh, it was so fun. It was so fun up until that Starforge. Chain stunning guy, shooting him. Candrus was clubbing him with his electric blackjack. T3 was there. Oh. It was just that Starforge. It was oddly short. It was just these overly long encounters. And then Malik was just dumb. Maybe if you saved Bastila, she'd help you on that fight. But then you have to use and like using Bastila. You always do it alone, that's dog shit. Terrible fight. I don't know why so many games have trouble tacking on boss fights and doing it wrong. Wags, was that the stun baton from the prologue? No, that was a Bothan stun baton we bought, which was a marginally stronger. I think instead of a Volker shock stick is 5 to 5, and that was like 7 to 7, and then with a strength modifier, that stun stick was doing 11 to 11 damage with Candrus's strength. I think a Taurus stun baton does 1 to 1. Yeah, it was a tricky story to tell. Because it's like Jedis are freakishly powerful in the rule set, and it's a story all about Jedi. So like all the non-Jedis in your party are kind of junk. And then I did purposely make myself not Jedi. Like maybe that fight's manageable if you are like a ripped Jedi, but that's definitely one of those boss fights that I hate in games where it's like the first time you go in there, you can get totally fucked over by the mechanics. Nonsense mechanics they invent for that one fight. So, I mean, like, if they ran out of money or time and they had to rush it, whatever, but definitely felt like things were getting a little trimmed down once we got to the Starforge planet. It was, like, just the two tribes that were, like, really flat. And the temple didn't really do anything except quickly wrap together the story, and then went to the Starforge, which was really short. Yeah, he has stats that cannot be obtained by a player. That's what they did in Baldur's Gate 1. It's the final boss I distinctly remember when we streamed Baldur's Gate is he had a spell that didn't exist in Baldur's Gate 1 except for him. Like, it existed in 3rd edition. But it was like, what did he do? Thaco loves 3rd edition. What did he do, Thaco? He, like, hit a trap inside a rune, which you can't do in Baldur's Gate 1. They don't add it till the second game, but... Yeah, just a boss that breaks all the rules of your game. Especially, I mean, in a Dungeons & Dragons-style game, which is just literally a game about rules and dice. And they had to break their own rules to make the game challenging near the end. I don't know. I fucking despise inconsistency in my games. I would have preferred, like, I would have remembered the game more fondly if we just beat the shit out of it. Because then it was just the fun stories. It was like, you know, and then Bastila's not getting my dick. And then we laughed, and then it plays the Star Wars ending credits. That would have been great. But just that huge spike on the Malik fight left a terrible aftertaste.
Ugh.
I mean, Malik did resist the stun a lot, but we did stun him once. But the problem was is he had a really unreasonable chance to resist, considering that I did have like +6 wisdom. What would have happened if I didn't have those thermal detonators? I probably would have saved Scum for about an hour and then rage quit. I had such a feeling Malik was going to be like that too after the Baldur's Gate final boss and like the dopey shit he had going for him. BioWare is just they have a little trouble with their bosses to make them tough. That's what I'll say. Yeah, they also had a lot of red herring dialogue choices in the Starforge, because there was clearly, like, there was probably a diplomatic way to deal with Bastila, but I think you still would have had to fight her a little bit. And there was clearly no way to talk. There was no way to talk down Malik. Probably the best we could have done was, like, make him repent after the fight. Have I ever played Jade Empire, by the way? Interesting move to request other BioWare games after I got that mad at that boss fight, but no, I haven't played Jade Empire. Ah, BioWare games I've played. Well, we played Baldur's Gate, played Knights of the Republic here. I've played Mass Effect 2. And I played Dragon Age 1. Did I like Dragon Age? I played Dragon Age on PS3, and I think the battle system was a little more convoluted than it would have been on PC, and I had to play through it like 3 times to get all the trophies, which was just mind-numbing, because they had really sweet shit like romance every single character, kill like 10,000 darkspawn. I didn't like the aesthetic of Dragon Age. It's like, I suppose it was an interesting world, but just everyone looked like inbred plasticine people, and I just hated the look of the armor. Character customization wasn't really the strong suit of Dragon Age 1. I mean, I think a lot of people didn't like Dragon Age 1. I think one of the most popular Dragon Age 1 mods is to remove the fade sequence because it was garbage. Oh, man, I wonder. I'm a little curious what that Malik fight looks like if you're an actual Jedi, because it seems like you're never. It seems like you would never quite be on his level on that fight, even though in the story you're supposed to be better than Malik, you're his master. It seems you'd have to be, like, really meticulously built to just school the shit out of him as a lightsaber Jedi. And destroy him with lightsabers? Yeah, man, it's like the sneak attack on the blasters is so fun, but watching that dude do fucking 70 damage to the lightsaber, my god. I mean, you probably shouldn't pity me. Never beat a game before, and I purposely did a dopey challenge run, but ugh. God damn it, the mechanics on that Malik fight. Starforge ended up being pretty short. We're not even at 2 hours for tonight. Actually, I just realized Fat Cow asked what I would have done if I didn't have the grenades, is I just realized that even if he passes the save on Paralyze, he still gets slowed. Although, no, I think resistance is he doesn't even get slowed, but we could have slowed him and then taken pot shots, because I think his lightsaber throw was doing just miserable damage. We could have tanked lightsaber throw. I'm not looking forward at all to whatever they do to make the final boss in Knights of the Republic 2 shit. It'll probably be a while before I go to that. See, if I go too scoundrel 18 consular, my force powers are pretty strong, but that's a little cheesy because you have to know, right? You have to know how the game works. It's like, I did some very preliminary reading of this. I was like, can I do it? That's what I Googled. I was like, can you fucking beat this game with blasters? And everyone was like, yeah, just stun shit, go consular. And then I purposely didn't read up because I would have found out about how garbage Malik was, and we could have been a little prepared for that, but. Yeah, I hate final bosses that are difficult because they introduce new mechanics. I'm still glad we beat it. We got to see the conclusion of Big Iron's story. And I hope you enjoyed it for your own reasons, both the blasting part and then the end where some people take an odd satisfaction in watching me get mad. But now we're just starting to ramble, so I think we're going to stop here, and then we'll be back Sunday with a new game, which will not be Knights of the Little Old Republic 2. I don't think I can stomach two of those back-to-back. But thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.